Guys, this time I will try Panfrost on my Rockpi4b SBC from Russia. Let's see how it performs. It's a driver on development by Alisa Rosenway. Let's try Shield Mark. You can compare this benchmark with your own board. The driver isn't finished. First, Alisa is trying to complete the 2.1 GL desktop version. Remember, this is GL desktop, not only GLS. And then when it's finished, we will have opengl 3.1, I assume, desktop version. And then on the long road, this board is Vulkan capable. Alicia will try to implement a Vulkan driver through his mesa driver, no? Vulkan capabilities. So yes, it's working fine for gaming. Remember, this is a driver on very early stages. So I can see my cursor. Zoom. Owlboy. Let's try Owlboy. Sound is working, but I have turned it off. Continue. We are running a 1080p monitor. So it will have a lot of glitches because, as I told you, the driver isn't finished, but it's Alisa is pushing fixes and working all the week, every day. I see a lot of pushes, even on weekends. So she will complete this. And complete this incredible project. This driver will reach eventually other boards like Odron and Ju, but I think the RK3399 will be the first SBCs on having a very solid Panfrost driver. So that's all. You can see all the glitches, but it's working. This game needs full opengl driver, so that's why I showed this specific game. This game doesn't run on OpenGL-S. So that's all, guys. This port is awesome for a desktop PC, ARM PC. I have to recommend it, even if you like Rockpi4, which is a great port, but hasn't haven't the features that this board has. This board has double USB 3.0 buffer, not shared buffer. This board has eMMC, which is in what I'm running now. This board has NVMe port, which runs really fast, and it's awesome. The on paper, taking aside the driver, the GPU is at least twice as fast than video card 6, so it's a very good board for to be a desktop PC or even running very demanding games. Right now, this driver is very experimental, very early on development, but we have it, we can test it, and I will update every week the driver to see any improvement on it. So that's all, guys. Thank to you all, and especially to Alisa Rosenweg, who developed this driver. Bye, guys.